Welcome to Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm Darren Myers. We are here at the Karate Pro Championships in Las Vegas at the Mr. Olympia Sports Fest. With me is former world champion Mr. Toki Hill, our promoter of the first Karate Pro Championships in the USA. Welcome, Toki.
Thank you, Darren. And man, what a week it's been. I mean, we got fighters from all over the world that are here at the beautiful Las Vegas Convention Center. On top of that, we are introducing Karate Pro. I mean, we got top 8 athletes in the world, top 2 female athletes in the world, and we're doing it in the best venue in the world with the best promoter in the world with the best fighters in the world. So we got $15,000 up for grabs. And on top of that, a championship belt.
Absolutely, Toki. These fighters have come from 7 different countries to compete today for this Karate Pro Championship in the United States. And this is the first of its kind, and it's right here at the Mr. Olympia Sports Fest.
Well, I'm going to tell you what. Stay tuned, people. You don't want to miss this. Hello, and welcome to Las Vegas, the Mr. Olympia, featuring Karate Pro. And with us is the president and the organizer of Karate Pro, Sensei.
Hello.
How are you finding Las Vegas?
It's a great city, very nice, I like it.
Is this the first time you've been to the Mr. Olympia?
Yeah, it's my first time I come here.
What do you think about the expo?
Oh, great. First time saw so very big exhibition.
Yes, sir. Now, 2 years ago, you and I had a conversation about Karate Pro 2 years ago. And now here we stand in Las Vegas at the Mr. Olympia featuring Karate Pro. How do you feel?
I feel I'm very nervous because first time, but I think many sportsmen wait this tournament, athletes. I think it will be very popular in the world and will be traditional.
I know that you helped handpick these competitors. What's your projection on who's going to win?
I don't know.
Go on. Very political. It's going to be a great event. And with me, Sensei Kagawa, how are you?
Hey, thank you, Andy.
I'm very well, thank you. And welcome to the United States and Las Vegas.
Yeah, I am half time. And so surprised.
Yeah, so this is your first time, Sensei, to Las Vegas?
Yes.
That's great. What do you think about the expo?
Yeah, surprise, so exciting.
Yes. Well, we have fighters here for Karate Pro from all over the world.
Yes.
We're going to bend out a lot of prize money.
Yeah.
And we're going to put on a big show for the Mr. Olympia.
Yes, so karate, so new style, open start. Mm. Yeah, very, very, so nice, so... So new idea.
Yes.
I hope.
Yes. Sensei, how do you feel about the boxing ring?
The boxing ring? Yes. Yeah, okay. No problem.
No problem.
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah, yeah. Good area. So yeah. The actual size of the tatami is 24 by 24.
Uh-huh. Yeah, good size.
Then a regular tatami on top of the mat.
Yeah, good.
Very yes.
Good, very good.
Okay, well.
Down, so very easy. Yes, very nice.
Great. Yeah. Well, we're gonna have a great show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Karate Pro Championships here in Las Vegas, Nevada at the Mr. Olympia Sports Fest. We have athletes from all over the world that are going to be competing today at this special event. This is the first of its kind in the United States. So we are very happy to be having this at the first Karate Pro Championship here in Las Vegas at Mr. Olympia. And I'd like to introduce our promoter, Mr. Toki Hill, who has brought this to Mr. Olympia.
Thank you, Darren, and thank you, everybody, for showing up, coming out to see what we're doing, and especially to the athletes and officials. It's going to be a great event. We have the top eight in the world here, and we can't wait to see these guys fight. So from here, I'm going to turn it over to the president of the KaratePRO, Sensei.
This is competition will be best of the best karateka in the world. I wish good luck for all sportsmen.
And our representative here of the officials, a longtime competitor herself and one of the world's leading officials that are here to oversee the event, Sensei Fariba.
Welcome everybody. It's going to be a great day for karate to take it to a really professional level, and I'm excited to be an ambassador of WKF, and I'm sure it's going to be a great event. So let the game begin.
All right, let's go.
With that being said, let's have our first competitors. First of all, coming from the Netherlands, in the red corner, weighing 85 kilograms, 187 pounds, Daniel Sabanovic. And in the blue, the only athlete from the USA, weighing 88 kilograms, 194 pounds, welcome from New York, Adham, Sabri.
I've been following the Olympia at home from the magazines and stuff, so I know what it is, and I know the athletes a little bit from who they are and what they can do, and it's really inspiring, and so it is amazing to be here at this moment.
Fantastic. Now, we're here, of course, for the KaratePRO tournament. This is a very different tournament from kind of what you're used to with WKF, isn't it?
Yeah. I have to be honest, the definite rules we get this afternoon. But the setting is different. It's in a ring, of course, which makes it quite interesting, because especially for the fighters who like to fight backwards, it will be a little bit tougher for them. But I think that will be a little bit advantage for me, because I like to press forward, depending on the adversary, of course. But yeah,
we want to represent the U.S. in the best way we can to keep that big medal home. We're going to fight our best. We're going to do our hardest to keep this gold medal here in our home country, America.
Now, Adham, we're fighting not just for the gold, but we're fighting for some big money here.
Yeah,
you think,
sure.
Think that's going to change your strategy a little bit?
Yeah, of course. You are fighting for a very huge prize. It's 15,000. Very good. And that's why I will get the gold medal here. I'm the youngest, but I don't care. I want the gold medal. Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show.
Thanks,
it's going to be a great event. As you can see, we have two of the top already in the ring. Welcome, Darren.
Good to be here, Toki. Thank you so much for this opportunity. It is exciting. We're at the first KaratePRO Championships in the United States.
And we have the top fighters in the world here.
That is incredible. We have got people from countries all over the world. And fighting right now, we've got Daniel Sabanovic from the Netherlands. And Daniel is actually 37 years old. That's up there to be fighting in this kind of championship, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely, Darren, but I'm going to tell you, $55,000 would bring a lot of people out of retirement.
I was thinking about it myself, I'll tell you.
I'd already thought about it.
I'm sure. And we've also got in the blue, Adham Sabri. Now, Adham is actually from New York. He's our only athlete from the United States, and he's 23 years old. Do you think that age difference is going to play a big part in this match?
Well, I think both of these athletes are very well versed in what they needed to prepare for it. It's different. The environment's different. They're fighting in a boxing ring versus... However, if you notice, there is a tatami on the floor.
Right, right. And that does make it a little better for the traction. It makes it better if they're thrown. So, you know, they're used to that tatami, the feel of that mat.
Yeah, and the rules, Darren, are a little different as well. There's a continuous movement. They're not allowed to tie up, keep each other balled up. The thing of it is, they're moving constantly in this ring. Constantly. So if you look at it from a boxing standpoint, you're using your upper body, lower body taekwondo. But here, they're doing both, hands and feet.
And they're trying to throw each other.
Absolutely.
As well. And I mean, when you tie up with somebody and you're trying to do exactly what they're doing right there, and look at him, he went down right there. That takes a lot of energy, and that'll take the wind out of you pretty quick. Now, in this match, they're getting 1 point for a punch to the body, 2 points for a kick to the body, or the punch to the head or body, 2 points for a kick to the body, and then 3 points that they can kick the head with good control or take the guy down and then score on him.
Absolutely. You know, it's so similar to the WKF.
It is, yep.
And slight rule changes. But of course, this is, you know, again, a perfect venue for these athletes to be able to showcase what they do best.
And they are good at it.
Man, I'm telling you what.
Look at the speed of these guys. I mean, they are just going at it.
Well, now, I seen them warming up yesterday,
right,
and today, and I'm glad I am retired.
You and I both, brother. Well, and there's also one extra type of point that they can get that you don't have in WKF. If they take the guy down, and even if they miss the punch, just the takedown scores a point.
Right, right, right. And you know, I really like that rule. I like that rule because a takedown a lot of times can be followed through with a stomp or, you know, a leg attack from the ground as well. That's a nice exchange right there.
Absolutely. Oh, nice sweep. Nice attempt there. Follows it up right up with the roundhouse kick.
I love the timing on Al.
Yep.
It closes the gap.
There. Yep. Checking him for some contact there, yep. And the contact rule in this is it's not a full contact type of fight.
Right.
This is, like you said, it's like the WKF where they have controlled contact to the head. I mean, they've got to hit it kind of light, but it can't knock a person out, can't cause blood, that type of thing, or they get penalized.
Absolutely, Darren, but that's the whole concept, you know, in karate do, the way, you know, to be able to control, throw it with a maximum amount of speed, maximum amount of power, and control it.
Yeah, and that's a lot harder than most people would think. I mean, it takes a tremendous amount of training.
I mean, look at the speed and accuracy on these athletes.
A lot different than you see in other martial arts, that's for sure. Oh, my gosh, what a punch they had. Oh. Look at that kick. Wow, that had to be a three-pointer right there. That was a beautiful hook kick.
Three.
They're continuing on here. All right, here we go again with round two. We got Daniel Sabanovic from the Netherlands in the red and Adham Sabri from the USA in the blue.
I'll tell you, again, Darren, I like both of these guys' movement. I like both of the ability to control the distancing.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. They are fast. Look how quick they are. They are so quick.
Now, they are allowed to also have a coach on the sideline.
Yes, and I think that really makes a difference when you've got somebody who can watch your fight, evaluate it, and help you change the strategy in the middle of things if things aren't going your way.
Right, right.
You know, so that's a big plus for those who have a coach with them today.
That initial takeoff, blitzing as we call it, you know, I think that he's got the timing down where he is actually controlling the fight right now.
Yes, I'd agree with you there. And Daniel in the red, what's interesting is he studied judo. So you're talking about somebody who understands throws and takedowns, and that could have a deciding factor when they get clinched like that.
Right, yeah. Well, we're here in beautiful Las Vegas. The Mr. Olympia, as you trying to get through this crowd, it's packed to the walls already.
It really is. I mean, this is quite an event. There are like 22 combat sports that are represented here.
Wow.
As well as all of the bodybuilding, the nutrition, the trade show.
Right.
It's amazing. There you are, right in front of us.
Almost in my lap. That was a good double leg take.
Yes, it was. Excellent.
So, you know, I see movement. I see stationary. I see movement, stationary. I mean, in interviewing some of these guys, what kind of strategies did they have for this fight?
You know, I think most of all, one of the biggest things is preparation. They've got to have the endurance.
Right.
Because, again, it's such a full body type of fight that it's tough. It's not like the WKF where you get to stop in between points. If somebody goes out of bounds, you stop for the penalties. These guys, it's continuous. And, boy, that really takes a toll on you. You don't get a break.
Yeah.
So that's got to be, first of all, but you've got to be the aggressor.
Right.
You've got to be the aggressor in order to go in and get the points and continue to get the points and cut your opponent off from getting points.
Well, you know, the other thing, it's hard enough to go 3-minute rounds.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So if you suffer a nose injury such as the USA fighter in blue did,
yeah,
you know, it's very difficult to maintain that breathing control with that injury.
Absolutely. And you got, you know, a padding stuff up your nose to control the bleeding. Yeah, he's having a hard time with that.
Yeah.
Here they go for round three, final round.
Well, there's $55,000 on the line, so you can bet I'd be moving.
Yeah, absolutely. Both of these guys, I mean, they got energy. Look at them.
Oh.
Look at that punch. Man, he's coming. Oh. Look at that kick. What a hook kick.
Now, see, the other interesting thing, they can grab
with both hands.
Yes.
Exactly, yes. And you can't do that in WKF. So this is a nice change for them.
Yeah, you could do a single-hand grab for a short period of time, right?
Right, in WKF. But here you can grab everything.
I'll tell you, there's a big difference from what happened in the midway of the second round to where how we started this round off now.
Yes, yes. I would say that we were looking at somebody starting to get a little tired there, but man, they're both starting off like they hadn't. This is their first round.
Absolutely.
You know, look at the energy in these guys.
Well, like you said, I mean, not only are they, you know, great competitors, yeah, but they're just great people.
Absolutely.
Great people.
Yeah, interviewing them, I mean, they were just as humble, and they weren't like a lot of the other professional sports you see where they were bad-talking and trash-mouthing, you know, their opponents.
That's right.
They were here. They were humble. They were nice. They were gentlemen, ladies. It's very nice to see that the respect and honor in karate is present here, even in this type of fight.
Right.
And, you know, afterwards, they're all going out to dinner afterwards.
You got it.
And we'll have a great time.
So what I really like, too, is once you see that they grab a hold of each other and they're, you know, it's not a long time gap in between there.
Right.
They're broke immediately and spread apart, and so they're made to go back into competition.
Yep, exactly. There was an attempt at a hook kick to the head and ended up losing balance and going down. He may have scored with that kick first, though. Coming up on a minute left in this final round of the first Karate Pro match here in Las Vegas.
The winner advances, the loser gets to take a long ride home.
Yep. Again, good with those kicks.
Yep.
Adam, if I tell you if that injury is taking any toll, it's not showing.
I'll tell you, I'm impressed with Al, the U.S. fighter in blue.
From New York, Adham Sabri, fighting Daniel Sabanovic from the Netherlands.
Right, we got great movement going.
Yep.
Again, Karate Pro is making their debut at the Mr. Olympia in Las Vegas, and we got a packed house here.
We really do. I trying to go through the aisles, and you can barely get through. It is packed to the gills. It's great to see such a showing for this.
Absolutely.
Especially being the very first karate pro in the U.S. Nice punches, good attempt for a throw.
We're going on, we're under 10 seconds.
Here we go.
It's going to be close, Darren.
It's going to be close.
And the end of that third round. Now we're going to wait for the officials. The officials to collect the scorecards and total them up. And we're going to see which athlete is.
What a fight! What a fight! Give it up for these athletes! Well, if that is the first fight, we have a great show ahead because that was an awesome, awesome fight. Thank you guys for giving it all you've got. Excellent job. We're here at the first Karate Pro Championships right here in Las Vegas at the Mr. Olympia Sports Fest. We've got fighters from all over the world fighting today to give you the best show we've ever seen and the first Karate Pro Championships in the United States. We're waiting now on the judges' decision. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner in blue from the USA, Adham Sabri. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready for our second fight of the day. First of all, in the red, from Belgium, weighing 74 kilograms, 174 pounds, Mr. Diego Vanderschrick. And in the blue corner, from Kazakhstan, weighing 118 kilos, 260 pounds, Khalid Khalidov. Now, what is your, you have a good strategy for this type of competition, since this is not a stop and award points type of competition like WKF. This is continuous. What do you think that's going to change your whole strategy for?
For me, it's not a problem. After that one technique, I just need a good protection, and it's not a problem for me. Good protection, good attention, and it's okay. It's okay.
This is going to be a very different contest with ropes, with different rules. What is your strategy for this?
I don't know. I'm only fight every time.
Just fight on. Do karate and give it your best.
Well, here we go, Darren.
Second fight. This is exciting. All right, we've got Diego Vanderschrick from Belgium in the red, going in fast right off the bat there. And he's up against, in the blue, Khalid Khalidov from Kazakhstan.
Right, and he won a previous karate pro in Europe.
Oh, wow, so he's got experience in this ring. He's probably one of the few that does. Now there's a good deal of weight difference here. You've got Diego at 174 pounds, 79 kilos. Blue is like 118 kilos.
Yeah, you know,
that's 260 pounds.
But that's the unique thing about Karate Pro. In the past, as you know, Darren, there was never weight divisions.
No.
In K1, there was not weight divisions. in the initial UFC, there weren't weight divisions.
Exactly, right?
You had so four. They just went at it.
And that's exactly what they're doing here. That was a nice takedown.
Well, looks like we
by Khalid there.
Knee.
Uh-oh. Let's hope he's not injured. He's limping off that, looks like that left leg quite a bit.
Right. The doctor is going to take a look at it. See.
Yeah,
it.
Diego is down on the mat with the doctor checking him out there. Hopefully that is not going to be a match-stopping type of injury.
Right.
It'd be a real shame to have him all the way over here from Belgium and get injured in the first minute of the match.
But then again, when you come back and you talk about it, even though they're extremely powerful, they're extremely fast, you know, you're giving up 100 pounds. So you go in there wrestling around with the bear, you're going to come out with a couple of scratches.
Yes, no doubt. No doubt. And I tell you, Khalid, he looks like a bear. All right, Diego is back up. It looks like he's good to go. Shaking off that left leg, so it's not 100%, which is...
We got a minute. We got a minute 59 still left in the first round. Whoa, look at that
technique. Wow, look at that takedown. Oh, my gosh.
So upper body, extreme fast movement, then followed through with a takedown.
Really good movement by Khalid.
He might appear to be a little heavy, but clearly in them movements there, he wasn't.
Yeah, he's strong.
They're using this first round here, a good filling out. But the second part of that first round, they're going at it.
No doubt about it, no doubt about it. And Khalid in the blue, he's been a world champ, an Asian first place champion. He was first place in the World University Games and also in the Asian Games. So this guy, he's got some serious ring time. Both of these gentlemen are in their 30s, so it's pretty close as far as age, but that weight difference is, you can tell it's there.
And plus, you know, the explosion. I mean, these guys are coming out of the hole so fast.
Yes, they are.
There's a lot of strategies and tactics here. We're coming on 10 seconds of the first round.
Oh, nice punch.
Yeah. So if you notice when the athletes try to use up that time and move around, these guys are on top of it, and I'm making them get right back into the competition.
They really are. They really are. So that's the end of the first round.
I'm sure.
And we're off. Second round, second match.
Both of them feeling each other out, trying to look for that opening. There we go. Whoa, what a takedown. Nice sweep. Diego came in with that first punch, but then Khalid just ran over him.
And the key to it is, Darren, that they have to immediately go into a defensive position, because what happens after that sweep, or before that sweep, he scores, he tries to backshift, and they're used to stopping to get that point.
Yeah, he is. You can tell that comes from all the WKF time he's had.
It's like any other style of fighting, though, Darren. These athletes will learn how to take these rules and move them into a positive tactic or strategy with it. There it goes again. They don't let them hang on each other.
No, they don't. No, they don't. They want them to fight. They want them to kick and punch. They don't want to turn it into a wrestling match. Uh-oh, no, the knee again. Oh, dear. He's down with the knee, and this time it doesn't look good. He's really holding that knee. He's rolling in pain. This is... Here comes the doctor to check him out again. And nothing really happened. I think he just landed on it and twisted.
Twisted, yeah. Is it his knee or is it his thigh?
I think it's the knee. It is that left knee that the doctor's got straightened out. Or that left side, anyway.
She's like, the chief official's coming over to... The doctor's in the ring with him now to see what's going on.
Yeah, you can tell he's still in pain. Okay, they're getting him up. Can he walk? There we go.
They're going to look at him more here. Looks like the doc is going to let the fight go. The doc's going to let the fight go, but let's see what the officials are going to do.
What are we doing? No. All right, they're going to continue the match. It's going to be a warning, but continue on with the match. So Diego's, like you said, he's sucking it up, ready to go. That's some spirit. That's some heart.
Okay, here we go.
Because he's got a long way to go in this match still.
We are a minute 12 into this, minute 12 into it. Second round.
Oh, nice exchange. Wow. Speed, timing, distance.
You know, as the evolution comes along, it's really, you know, for me, sitting back here, of course, it's easy to say. I'm not up in that ring. But, you know, after, I'm looking for more lateral sporadic type movement, Darren.
Right, especially with this continuous movement. You don't want to just go straight in.
Right.
You've got to move around. You've got to be more of an angled fighter.
I see him pulling that leg. I just seen that. I think he's having a lot of problems with that.
Yep. What's going to be real...
10 seconds, Darren.
If he makes it all the way through the second match here, what's going to be tough for him is sitting out... That knee getting cold, and then having to go into another match if he wins this.
Well, that's the end of this round.
All right, final match. Final round for this one. Diego Vanderschrick in the red from Belgium, and Khalid Khalidov from Kazakhstan.
It's interesting, the body posturing.
Whoa, nice attempt at a spin kick there. Caught him right on the hip.
I mean, these athletes are in condition.
They
are.
I mean,
to take a shot like that and be able to continue.
Shake it off and keep going. That shows some real heart and some real physical fitness.
I think you're going to find a lot of crossover from the karate world, without a doubt, coming forward. But I think the bigger... crossover you're going to find is from the other sports, boxing, taekwondo, these other sports. I think that...
I think you're right, Tokyo. I think they're going to see what is available in this kind of arena, and it's very attractive. It's You talk about the money, you talk about the kind of competition. It's exciting for a competitor. Man, it's all about getting in there and mixing it up. And these guys are definitely mixing it up. Yep, trying to keep that leg out of things. That's smart fighting.
Minute 30 into the last round. Three rounds, total score of the three rounds.
Nice punches by Diego there.
I think Diego knows that he's got a comfortable lead. And basically he's trying to take this round, fill this round out. I mean, you know, run the time down, have action, but conserve as much energy as he can.
Exactly, because the winner's got a long way to go to get to the top prize.
35 seconds left in the match. There's some very good upper body movement.
Absolutely. They're really moving sideways. Get out of the way. That's good. That's what these fighters have to do in this kind of match, is move at angles.
10 seconds.
Here we go.
$15,000 and advancing towards it right here, right now.
All right, that's the end of the third round. Waiting on the judges now.
This is going to be a hard call, Darren, for sure. For sure. The judges are putting the scores together. I just looked up in the corner. I know he's having problems with his knee, but he looks like he's doing. Well, it looks like it's a close match here. We're going to find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of three rounds, we have a tie.
Oh.
So,
at the end of three rounds.
One round to Diego, one round to Khalid, and one round tied. So now, they must fight one more deciding round.
As the center referee brings the fighters in, here we go. 3 minutes for the winner to advance forward. He's going after that leg. Being strategic.
But in order to get the points, you've got to attack. You have to attack.
For sure. For sure, there needs to be a lot.
Uh-oh. Oh, there went a nice kick to the body by Khalid. And a takedown as well.
And as you can see, there's great sportsmanship.
There really is. That's during the middle of the match as well.
And there's a lot on the line here. I mean, the winner moves forward. Again, the loser goes home.
The winner of the men's ends up with $15,000.
And a beautiful belt.
Absolutely. Nice punch by Diego and a return kick by Khalid.
What a great venue for a great event.
This is beautiful. Absolutely fantastic. It's so professionally done. Walking in here yesterday, I was very, very impressed. So a terrific debut for Karate Pro here in the USA.
Just under a minute in the first round. This one round is going to determine who moves forward.
This is the tiebreaker. Nice punches. Diego trying to protect that leg.
He's showing a lot of heart, though. He's staying in there.
I know it's got to be tough for him because you really can't kick, and that's where you get the higher points is from kicking.
Right. And they still hold the philosophical concepts of the martial arts. Discipline, control.
Respect. That's something missing so much today. Is respect, and these guys, they show it. And
absolutely.
There's the end. That's it.
Yeah. Well, that's the end of the round. I'll tell you, it's...
That's the end of the deciding bout. We'll hear from the judges here on who wins and who advances. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are, Las Vegas. First Karate Pro Championships in the United States. Waiting on the decision in our second round fight.
We have our decision here.
All right, we have our competitors to the middle. We have a decision. And your winner of this match from Kazakhstan in the blue, Khalid Khalidov.
Wow, great match, great match.
Excellent match, gentlemen. Good job, congratulations. In the red, all the way from Japan, Hideyoshi Kagawa. Hideyoshi's 115 kilos, 253 pounds. Facing in the blue from France at 98 kilos, 216 pounds, Florian Malguy.
Next, WKF, I challenge championship.
Oh,
yes.
For the world championship?
Yes.
Ooh, fantastic. Are you looking forward to the Olympics?
Yes, 4 years ago, 2020.
And will be in your town,
yes.
Your city.
Je pense que ça va être un moment fort avec les athlètes puisque c'est tous des grands champions. Et donc ici à Las Vegas, c'est une bonne chose, un bon commencement.
He's saying that it's going to be a very strong competition. Indeed, all the competitors are very, very strong, and it's going to put on a good show, especially in Vegas here. It fits very well.
Three rounds, 2 minutes each. 3 minutes each.
With 1 minute in between.
Referee is ready to start the bout.
We have three rounds, 3 minutes, 2 minute rest in between each round.
That's a long time to fight.
And the winner will move closer to that $15,000 check. Nice movement already. Darren, you give these guys weight earlier. How much do they weigh?
Well, you're looking at here, there's a considerable weight difference. You've got Florian Malguy in the blue from France. He's at 98 kilos, 216 pounds, which that's a good sized guy. Hideyoshi from Japan is 115 kilos. That's 253 pounds. So you got a 250-pounder against a 210-pounder.
But you know, if you watch, well, as you can see, they have total respect for each other. That's not, just like the last match.
Absolutely, absolutely.
They got total respect for each other, but these guys move like they're a lightweight.
Absolutely. I mean, these are serious heavyweights right here. And look at them go. That's impressive.
Equipment adjustment.
And what's amazing is they move so fast, but the power they've got, and they control that power. They're not hitting as hard as they can, but I guarantee you would feel it. Great timing by both competitors. Florian in the blue, he's 33 years old.
Right.
And he's been training in the martial arts almost 30 years. Started when he was four.
Absolutely.
4 years old, and that's really what you see a lot these days. You see kids starting at very young ages in karate. And this is what happens, you know, by the time they get to adult, they're an international competitor.
Yeah, but look at where he ends up.
Yeah, exactly.
Where he ends up. He's in one of the biggest venues in the country, or the world, excuse me.
Absolutely.
The Mr. Olympia. In a competition where there's $55,000 and the right to brag is number one.
You're right. And the first Karate Pro champion of the United States. So
we're at 1 minute.
It's a lot going on. Now Hideyoshi, of course, is all the way from Tokyo, Japan.
Right. Right.
29 years of age.
Right.
He's at 253 pounds. This is a good-sized guy, but he moves, like you said, like a lightweight. And he's an office worker. He works as a clerk in an office. He's been training only 15 years, which really for a competitor of this elite status, that's not a long time.
Right, right. Well, I mean, these guys have accolades that roll like a dictionary. But, you know, the intensity they put in each competition, it's like you would think it's their first championship.
Yep.
And that's the end of the first round. And now, here we go, starting the second round to the next level.
And Florian goes right in for a punch, but look at the combination of kicks he's trying to throw. And this is not a small guy.
Florian didn't even sit down
in
the corner.
That's right.
He didn't even sit down. His versatility of his hands and his feet, the combinations, and little taunting and the distancing, I think.
Oh, look at that kick. Great kick.
But great control.
Absolutely. Tapped him right on the side of the face and got the 3 points. And you don't think of a big guy like Florian as a kicker.
No.
You know, usually the bigger guys are the punchers, they're the heavyweights, they're the ones that kind of stay rooted on the floor. But he's got all the tools.
Notice in between there's a lot going on with the equipment.
They're using the WKF style equipment that is used in WKF matches and will be used in the Olympics. These are not like boxing gloves or big MMA type gloves.
Right.
Really, the gloves are more of an in case somebody makes a mistake. They're not for full contact hitting.
Well, you know, it's kind of amazing how two athletes can actually convert at each other and still throw with that type of speed and power and control it.
Absolutely, really is. Because you think both of these guys, they're moving as fast as a human body can go when it's trained well, and yet they still keep their punches from penetrating and hitting and causing injury.
Absolutely. But if you on the flip side of it is, if you watch the focus that they have on the techniques as well, that it keeps it going.
Yeah, and you can tell that if they got in a real fight in a back alley, they'd be taking it to another level.
Okay,
oh, there's a good
takedown.
No chance for a follow-up because of great cover by Florian.
But with the new rule and how it works, he will still get a point for the takedown.
That's right. Hideyoshi would score on that.
About 45 seconds left in this round. I'm surprised how these heavyweights can keep their hands low and they just have that speed to be able to get that hand up, maintain that distancing, and counter.
Exactly. Right, look at that punch. Look at that counter by Kagawa right there. You're exactly right. They have the quickness to be able to do anything they want.
Hey, coming up on the 10-second mark. And here we go, they're still at it in the corner.
Yep, an attacking punch and a counter punch.
Right.
Great timing by both athletes.
And there we are.
All right, into the second round.
Did you have an opportunity to throw a plug out there for Black Belt Magazine?
I did,
yeah,
I did.
What a great guy, Robert Young.
Absolutely.
I've known him for many years, and he's just a encyclopedia, a history book on martial arts.
No doubt. All right, so here at the beginning of round three, the final round here in this match, this first round match, between Florian Malguy of France and Hideyoshi Kagawa from Japan. Oh, Hideyoshi's, you think he knows he might be a little behind?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Besides that, Florian ain't taking no chances whether he's going to cruise through this round or not. He wants this round as well.
They're going hard. They're going, Hideyoshi is working something on his right leg there that may be bothering him.
There's 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in this round. This is the second athlete to have an issue with the knees.
Yes. And this is got to be tough on the body when you're looking at, nice punches. Nice punches by Hideyoshi. Really strong. But yeah, this sport definitely has takes a toll on the body because you're not just working the legs like in Taekwondo. You're not working just the arms like in boxing. This is a total body. Plus, you've got the throws and takedowns like in Judo and Jiu-Jitsu.
Absolutely.
Yep.
I'm really impressed by Florian Enbo, how quick he is and smooth when he moves.
Very smooth, very smooth. He makes it look easy.
Yeah, yeah.
And we both know it's not easy. Especially when you're fighting guys of this caliber, it's just, you got to be ready on your toes, taking it to them the whole entire fight.
Absolutely. I'm without a doubt assured that Florian's probably one of the best conditioned athletes at this event. He's not even breathing hard. He's still got spring in his legs, you know.
He looks like he's fresh. You're exactly right. He really looks fresh and ready to go for more.
Nice counterpunch, nice control of the distancing, and then right back with the counterpunch. It was an excellent job.
Very impressive. Very
44
impressive.
Seconds in the last round.
Seconds left.
Yeah, he's coming right back at him. We're coming up on 15 seconds left.
Look at that, Malguy still attacking hard. And Hideyoshi coming right back.
Yep, they're pushing on this last round.
They're
and
trying
that's
to-
it.
Nice work.
Now it goes to the judges. Stay tuned for the winner.
All right, there we go with another three rounds. Let's give these athletes a hand. Awesome job. Very impressive fights. And as we wait for the judges' decision, we appreciate everyone being here for the very first KaratePRO Championships in the United States. This is an honor to have it at the Mr. Olympia Sports Fest. And we're very happy to be here with athletes from all over the world. Some of the best trained athletes and several world champions. And this fight ends the first round of competition for all of the athletes. All right, we have a decision. From Japan, Hideyoshi Kagawa! All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready for the first fight of round two. In the red, from Turkey, weighing 111 kilos, 245 pounds, Yaser Sahintekin. And in the blue, 88 kilos, 194 pounds, from the USA, ladies and gentlemen, Adham Sabri. Now, this is a very different kind of karate match than you're probably used to with WKF. Because you fought many times WKF. You've been a junior champion.
And you've been a WKF Karate League medalist, right?
Yes, right. It is so different than karate, but WKF rules. But it will be a three round here. I think it's round system is very good for us because we need the time show to for us to in the fight. We need time. It's very good. Three round and 3 minutes. It will be harder than WKF, but I think it will be fine.
Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen, to the next fight. And this, I am going to assure you, is going to be an exciting bout. USA fighter in the blue, Turkish fighter in the red. Both of these very experienced.
Nice kick to the body.
Yaser is a well-experienced competitor, athlete. I've known him for many years. His accolades are just impeccable.
Adham Sabri, he's from New York, but originally out of Egypt.
Yeah, you mentioned that. And besides that, he's a 10-time national champion.
From Egypt.
From
absolutely.
His native country. And as you say, he now resides in New York. Trained by Adele Sensei, which I've known for many years. Is a great competitor in his day. Besides that, moved into the coaching world.
Both of these athletes, very nice, very respectful, very, really a pleasure to interview earlier.
Right.
And both of them just have the heart for karate. They were both like, you know, we're glad there's money involved, but we're here because it's a competition. And that really shows heart.
Well, as you've seen in the first round, the American fighter suffered a blow to the nose, which really hurt his breathing. And look at him now. He's like he's never competed.
Exactly, exactly. And in a combat sport, any combat sport, really, and you've got to be able to take the lickings and just keep on going, too.
There you go.
And it's that perseverance that really karate develops and really brings out in a person.
Yeah. Yes. But, well, you know, the other thing, Darren, is these athletes are really exaggerating the points so that they're making sure that the official sees it.
Very much so. And it's very clean technique as well.
Right, right. We're under 1 minute of this round.
There's quite a weight difference. There's about 50 pounds difference between these two athletes. And, you know, that really makes a difference when you're trying to throw somebody.
Or you're getting thrown.
Yeah, exactly. No doubt. Yaser from Turkey, he's been training 25 years. And karate is really, I mean, in his whole family.
Right.
He's been a world and European champion. And he's on the Turkish national team.
And that's the end of the first round. There goes the chairs. Here comes the fighters. And we're starting the second round.
There goes Sabri straight in for the head kick. And they're trying to throw each other down.
Well, you know, I think his speed I mean, look at him. He looks like he's 20 years old on top of it.
Yes. Yep. Speaking of age, Adham is 23 years old, but Yaser is 31. So that's quite a number of years to give up.
Right.
Oh, Adam's quick.
Oh,
nice.
That's not good.
Uh-oh. We may have an injury here.
He attacked with that lead hand. Looks like he's his mouthpiece. Whether he's knocked out, he got up within the 10 seconds.
Yeah, but
he got up within the 10 seconds. So as far as the rules go. I hope that that's not his teeth laying on the ground up there.
I hope you're right there. And he was weaving a little back and forth getting back to his ring.
It was
so he took a good shot.
It was clearly accidental.
Yeah.
Both athletes were attacking each other at the same time. You know, there was no malice in it. No, you know, it's just one of those things that happened.
Well, when you got two athletes moving at warp 11, something's bound to happen once in a while, that's for sure.
Stay tuned. We're going to find out exactly what the officials have to say.
Doctor is checking him out at this point, seeing if he's clear to continue. Adham is the only USA athlete in this competition today. Really a chance to bring in athletes from all over the world.
Well, he's up on his feet.
Looks like the doctor has cleared him for it.
Yep.
Doctor says he's good to go.
Gave him the thumbs up.
That's great.
He was up within the 10 second, the required time. He's got his son, yeah. In. Good sportsmanship, touching gloves.
There's a penalty to Red, to Yaser, for the contact, but it still wasn't deliberate.
Yeah.
Oh, nice shot by Adham, and Yaser comes right back with one. Nice punches continuing on.
We're right under 2 minutes. This is the third round, and I'll tell you, I don't know, even though there's a penalty, I can't really determine, you know, I mean, they're both throwing leather.
They're both strong, and they're still strong. Endurance has not been a factor in this fight.
Right.
These guys are in shape. Look at Adham dancing around the ring.
Yeah.
There you go, wow. He just dances and charges right in. He's quick.
There's a lot on the line. A lot on the line. But to these guys, it's a notch in the belt. That's what they want. His legs are so flexed. What happened? What happened there, Darren?
I think there was a call to stop by the referee, and somebody didn't stop.
Right. I'll tell you what. I just got a wink from him.
Yeah.
My man.
Well, you know, when you're in the heat of the moment. Oh, look at that punch. Whoa, there we go. When you're in the heat of the moment, sometimes you don't even hear the referee. You know, you're just focused on the fight so hard that nothing else is even in your
side view. We're under 1 minute. He needs to get out of that corner.
There you go. And if this was a WKF event, they probably would have been out of the ring there. But it's interesting fighting with the ropes.
Well, that stops that strategy or that tactic of being able to before that 10 seconds step out and then after that 10 seconds.
Exactly.
That's what I'm saying earlier, Darren, is about how these athletes adapt to these rules and then learn how to bend them and twist them.
That's so true. You know, every time in the WKF there's been a rule change, you think, oh my gosh, you know, what are the athletes going to do? But they adapt quick and they adapt well. And they use those rules to their advantage.
Right. I'll tell you what, the contact, these guys have no problem getting hit or hitting.
No, not at all. Nobody's batted an eye getting hit. They got 15 seconds left in the last round.
I hope you're keeping score out there in the audience. Wherever you're viewing from, welcome to Las Vegas. We're under 5 seconds. Oh, again, there's that lead hand. His lead hand is so quick.
Extremely quick, and he is just a great athlete. So here we go, getting ready to start round number 3 against Yaser Sahintekin from Turkey and Adham Sabri from the USA. Nice sweep by Turkey, and there's a point there. That is a 3-pointer. That's a big way to start this final round match here. And in goes a nice punch by Sabri. He is a very quick young athlete. Sir, you can tell he wants to go in and try to do that takedown again and score the 3 points. And he's got 50 pounds on Hadam. So that weight can make a difference, especially when you're trying to throw somebody to the ground. Good speed again by Adham going in. There it goes again. Adham with that quick front hand punch. Nice lateral movement by Adham. But yes, sir, he stays on the attack. He can tell he's hunting him down, trying to make a throw again. There's a sweep attempt. Good punch to the head by Yasser. Punch and counter. There's another attempt by a sweep. We've got 1 minute left in this final round. Little equipment malfunction here. A Nice kick by Adham. Very nice kick. He hook kick right to the back of Yasser's head. That too is a three-pointer, so Adham is racking up some points here. Yaser, you can tell he is trying to make that throw so he can get 3 points. Another attempt at a good kick by Adham. Great block by Yaser. We're down to 6 seconds.
This is the third and final round, Darren.
And that's it.
The winner advances, the loser is out.
Actually, the loser's gonna go for third place, so they'll fight again.
Oh, okay. So we're at the semifinals, moving up. The officials are totaling up the scores. We're getting the sheets collected, and we're going to find out who moves forward towards that $15,000. Stay tuned.
Here we are, waiting the decision of the judges. All right, ladies and gentlemen, our decision has, judges have come to a decision to advance on into the next round. Our winner, in the blue from the USA, Adham Sabri! We are ready for the third place match in the Karate Pro Championships and a chance for one of these athletes to win $5,000. And for the third place match, we have in the red from Turkey, Yaser Sahintekin! And in the blue, coming from Tokyo, Japan, Hideyoshi Kagawa! This is for third place and $5,000.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. The bronze medal match, $5,000 and bragging rights.
This is starting off strong, Toki. These are some big guys we've got fighting.
And looks like they got a little more pep into the movement now.
Absolutely. Hideyoshi from Japan, he's 253 pounds. And Yaser is no small guy from Turkey. He's 245, so they're pretty evenly matched. Oh, look at the kick from Yaser. That's got to be a three-pointer.
I'm amazed, Darren, at the versatility of what these athletes are able to do and the size of them.
Absolutely, and look, there comes Hideyoshi right back with the head kick. And, you know, they've been fighting a long time already.
Absolutely. 1 minute down in the first round. We're going to go 3 rounds, 3 minutes, with a two-minute rest in between. Both competitors filling each other out, checking that distance.
Oh, wow, what a good attack and counter by both of them.
Both of these athletes are extremely experienced, have a lot, a lot of versatility, in where they fought and what they've done. It's just
no doubt about it.
Now they're here at the Karate Pro, Darren.
Exactly. And I mean, we've got the best in the world here. Yaser, he was a world champion and a European champion.
Yeah, I've had the opportunity to see both these guys fight. Yaser from Turkey, one of the all-time greats, without a doubt. Not only is he a kilo fighter, individual fighter, but he's also a starter on the very prestigious Turkish national team for many years.
Exactly. And you know that experience, I mean, that pays off when you get into a bout like this.
Yes. I'll tell you, when you talk to these guys, I mean, even though they're big, they're strong, I mean, you look at these exchanges. You know, they're like teddy bears.
Exactly. But they're really good teddy bears. And very strong ones at that. And like you said, Tucker, they both have been competitors, top competitors on their respective teams here. Hideyoshi, he's actually been training 10 years less than Yaser, though.
Oh, yeah. And that's the end of the first round.
It's those intrinsic lifetime values that karate teaches that's really what sticks with a person. And you know, even if somebody trains in karate for a good number of years and then quits, those life values stick with you.
Yes, yes.
And those moral principles, they stick. And so that's why karate is very popular among the youth these days. Parents want to see kids train in something that's going to be good for them morally and going to teach them respect and honor.
I see right now, I can already see a trend happening with the Karate Pro. What's going on is these athletes are using that lead hand, coming back, regrouping, burning that time up and then coming with that lead hand.
Right, right. Well, that lead hand's quick, and it's the closest thing to the opponent, so, yeah, they're definitely taking advantage of it. Look at Kagawa going in with a barrage of punches.
And believe you me, if that was on the street or somewhere else,
oh,
they would be effective.
I wouldn't mind having him in my corner in a back alley.
In the second round, we're halfway through. Both fighters know what's at stake here. Good poise in the ring. Just think, there's a lead hand at both of them. Both exchanges, you know, they both scored.
It's like simultaneous. Their timing is incredible.
Coming up on the 1 minute mark of the second round. The Turkish fighter in red, yes, sir. Seems to be going, pushing forward, putting the pressure on Darren.
Yes, but I tell you, Kagawa is bringing it right back to him as much as he can. Look at that, Kagawa going in with that lead punch again, like you were just talking about.
But he's got to move. He's got to use it more. He's
yeah.
not using it enough.
Yeah.
I mean, he's racking. Every time he does it, he racks up points. But, you know, he's not throwing it enough.
Right, right.
I mean, from here, it looks like it's scored almost every time he's thrown it.
I agree with you. Absolutely. He's very precise with where that punch is going and very quick with how it goes in. There he goes again. And a nice barrage of punches.
And so even Yaser, the in red, the Turkish fighter, is counter-punching him. However, as the rules in the sport evolves, Karate Pro, you're going to see how they're going to angle and manipulate out of that.
And they're both doing a great job with it. So that's the end of round two. So here we go with round number three, the final round in the third place match at the Karate Pro Championships in Las Vegas.
Yes,
indeed. Here they go.
Both athletes being cautious, and then boom, off they go. Right off the line, Darren.
Yep.
Nice exchange.
Look at that. Bang, bang. I mean, it is one after another. They're right in there at the same time. It's incredible.
He takes off with that punch. He scores every time. Then he stops. Yes, sir. What? Counters immediately.
Yep. Nice attempt for a kick, but I think Kagawa got a good block on that.
Kagawa has a very, very difficult. Very difficult, awkward type fighting style.
Yes. Yeah, he's more of a stand there. Oh my gosh, he's more of a stand there and explode off his stance.
Absolutely.
More like you see a lot of Japanese fight like that.
Now we're moving into the corner, trying to trap him.
There it goes. Kagawa just pushing on.
I think the majority of these athletes, other than Florian, I think that they understand a big component of their tactics are going to have to be conditioning.
No doubt. In this fight, I mean, you're fighting for 9 minutes, and that's not your only fight. You know, you've got to come up the brackets to get to the championship fight, and by that time, you've done a lot of ring time.
Yeah, absolutely. Listen, you know, the fighters are, you know, everybody thinks it's physical. It's extremely mental. These guys already got the physical. You know, they got the speed. They have the technical skills. They have the training. The thing of it is that mental ability to apply those strategies and tactics.
Absolutely, and you know, it's been very interesting watching these fights so far because technically everybody's very equal. They're very much on the same level as far as what their technical abilities are. So it's got to come down to a strategy of outthinking your opponent.
Absolutely. We're under the 30-second mat, 30-second, excuse me, of this last and final round.
And it for third place.
Now they're picking it up. You're under 10 seconds now. Everybody's
got to impress the judges that one last time. Oh, nice punch by Yasser as Kagawa tried to spin into it. But look at him go.
Found out that the Japan and Turkey actually tied the match. So the points are equal, so they have to do an extra bout to determine the bronze medal. Winner. Good luck to both of them. Thank you.
All right, so after reviewing the scorecards, the match between Yaser and Japan, Kanagawa from Japan, Kagawa, we are going to have a tiebreaker. There was a tie in that match, and now this is a tiebreaker round. So ladies and gentlemen, a tiebreaker round for third place.
And $5,000.
This is for $5,000 between Yaser, Sahintekin, and Hideyoshi Kagawa.
As you can see, they're going for it. There was a mistake in the scorecard, as I understand it, Darren.
Yeah, they unfortunately had a mistake in the basically adding it up, and it came to a tie. So after reviewing the scorecard, they found out we had a tie between Yaser here and from Turkey and Kagawa from Japan.
Yep.
So now they are fighting a tiebreaker. And that was unexpected, but I know these guys are going to give it their all. They've had a really good break.
Well, they gave it their all in the first time.
They sure did. No doubt about it. So much so that the judges thought it was a tie, so obviously.
Well, both fighters are awesome, and, you know, you can't take nothing away from their body kick, followed through with a punch. And again, these two fighters putting it all on the line for $5,000 and third place overall.
There we go, mixing it up.
Halfway through the first, or this final round, I should say. A minute 20 left. Both of these fighters being very, very smart.
Yeah, it's all about points here.
Whether it's clean, you know, the techniques from both athletes are exceptional. They have the criteria that the point requires. And on top of that, there's just multiple techniques.
They are, and I tell you, as a judge, this is difficult, very difficult to judge.
Well, and
it's
really
so
is
fast.
Because the techniques are so fast and so big, and there's multiple because you can score, they can score, you can score, they can score. So, you know, a lot of times, even the aggressor ends up not being the aggressor.
Absolutely, yes. And, you know, as a judge, you can't take your eyes off the action for a second.
Well, it's difficult to try to find, you know, who hit first. But in this case, they both score.
Right. There it is, they're down.
Yep.
They're down to just a few seconds left.
We're coming up, that's it. Nope, 2 seconds left, and that's it. The time is up.
All right, this is it, third place.
We're gonna go one more time and try to find out what we got here. Stay tuned for the decision for third place, Japan against Turkey.
Let's hear it for these athletes. What a fight. That was for third place and for $5,000. So here we are waiting on the judge's decision one more time. With these athletes and the speed and precision of them, very difficult for judges to make a call on this. They have to be actually totaling up points several at a time, with these athletes throwing points back and forth, almost simultaneously. So here we go, we're getting our decision now. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have our decision. The score from the judges, 22-20. From Turkey in red, Yaser Sahintekin. All right, ladies and gentlemen. And to present the check now for $5,000 for third place. Our promoter, Mr. Toki Hill. Our winner, Yaser Sahintekin from Turkey. So let's bring out our fighters for the final match of the evening. In the red, from the USA, welcome Adham Sabri. And in the blue, Khalid Khalidov.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
This is for all of the marbles, $15,000 cash and the championship belt.
I don't know what I'd want more, the belt or the money. Nah, I'll just take them both.
Here they go, the big one.
But you know what? That's good sportsmanship. It was an issue, it was corrected, and we move forward.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And it's three-minute matches with 2 minutes in between rest for $15,000, the title belt, and bragging rights.
Especially bragging rights.
Well, I'm going to tell you what. Whoever takes us out of here earned it.
No doubt about it. No doubt about it. Every one of those athletes did a fantastic job and earned it all today. Earned the respect.
So these two athletes are really filling each other out, Darren.
Yes, well, you know, and this happens a lot of time in the very top match because you've got the two best athletes of the day. And they're
clearly
going for all the marbles, and if you make one mistake going in, you know your opponent's going to capitalize. Wow. Fantastic. Trying to kick to the head and taken down and scored on.
Well, you know, looky here. The bottom line is you get your leg up, you need to get it back down and get it down quick.
That's for sure.
But it's been, what an exciting show. Karate Pro, the future for professional karate.
Yeah, Toki, I'm really looking forward to seeing more of this in the future. And I think it's going to become very popular.
Well, yeah, the audience we had was extremely Karate Pro.
Yes.
Well received.
Very receptive to it, and they were very excited to see these matches. So Adham Sabri from the USA in red, and Khalid Khalidov from Kazakhstan. In the blue, in Kazakhstan, is where this concept came from.
Absolutely. Since Joslav is one of the key drivers within this. Oh, there was a nice spin kick, but it was off.
Yep.
Off target.
Adham moved in on that very well. Avoided the contact and the point.
It's interesting. I don't see. I see him with a lot more strategy in this fight versus, well, that's it right there. That's the first round down. And I'm going to tell you, there wasn't a lot of action. All right, we're coming up.
Yeah,
absolutely. We're coming up on the 10 seconds right now.
And you get 1 point if you throw the guy down. Even if you miss with a follow-up technique, you still get 1 point for the throw. Right. That's a nice concept. It encourages the throwing a lot more. And let's face it, that's exciting to see.
Sure. Absolutely.
All right. These guys are, they are ready to go. Wow.
Here we go, back to this, you know, posturing position again.
Yeah, now I'm not sure in this kind of match, a defensive strategy is what you want.
Yeah, especially with the officials. You know, we clearly seen a much different fighter in the first two rounds from the American in red.
Yeah, and he's fighting somebody who's a lot heavier than he is, so trying to take Khalid down is going to be a little tougher. He's shorter, he is more compact, and he's heavy. And this is an interesting match because you've got one of the Adams, one of the lightest competitors of the whole tournament, and Khalid's one of the heavier ones.
You know, again, they got to move. I think that the fighter that has the most movement is going to win.
Yeah, you've got to have that offensive, aggressive attack in everything that you do, and you can't sit down and just wait for the other guy. They're playing with each other now.
Well, I don't. Clearly, unless they're saving it for the last round, but they got to remember that last match.
Wow! Okay, there you go with the three-pointer.
The last round might not be the round. If you
exactly.
lose two before that last round, you're going to win.
That's exactly right. You've got to keep going. You can't take it light at any time during this match. Look, now this is what we're expecting. That's a good exchange.
And both offensively and defensively.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So. Yeah. See the. The American fighter is not as explosive in movement as he was in the earlier match.
Now, oh, sure.
When he does move, he's springy. You could see it. But, you know, I don't know. I would never count on the officials.
Right.
I mean, you're 25 seconds into the second round. Now, I don't know what's going on here, but he just woke up. He must have heard
absolutely.
me.
I think he did. I think he did. I think he's listening to you.
Running around.
He's got a Bluetooth in his head.
There you go.
So look at it.
5 seconds.
The expression on Adam's face, I mean, he wants this bad. There you go. Into the second round. All right, here we go with the final round. Between Adham Sabri of the USA in red and Khalid Khalidov of Kazakhstan in the blue.
The winner takes $15,000, the belt, and bragging rights.
Wow, look, with Khalid's coming out with a spinning hook kick.
If it would have hit him, it would have.
Oh, my gosh. Yep. Adham is light on his feet, though. He is moving. And I think this is a classic display of lightweight versus heavyweight. You know,
yeah.
Their lightweight is doing the right thing. He's dancing around. The heavyweight is standing his ground, and he's ready to fire just like that.
But I'll tell you, this could backfire on him too, because if he doesn't do something after moving to move forward.
Absolutely. Now, see that? Wow.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, ow. Okay, now that was a throw, but I think Adam really hit right on his head. That was a hard hit on the floor.
Yeah, I think that they're calling the physician into the ring just to make sure everything. But I'll tell you, what a What a great throw.
That, then what a great just exchange there. Adham came rushing in, hit Khalid, but then Khalid came with a barrage of punches after that, ended up in the corner, and Khalid came out with a throw, throwing Adham out of the corner, but unfortunately I think he landed on his neck and head. So hopefully he's okay there and we can continue the match. But yeah, what an exchange. These the guys are really going for it. The doctors are evaluating now, and
let's hope he's all right.
Yeah, Adham, he looks good over there.
He seems like he's responding well.
Yep.
The doctor gives him a thumbs up.
All right, we're good to go. Look at him, he's got the energy. He's telling his opponent, I'm ready, bring it on. Look at that, nice respect between the competitors. Here we go. We've got 2 minutes, just over 2 minutes in this final round. There's Adham with a good punch. I don't think that could be classified as a throw. It looked more like a slip.
Yeah, the equipment adjustment. Both of these fighters are giving it all they got. They, you know, it's been a long day. I'm sure they're exhausted, but there's a lot on stake for this, too.
There really is.
The money, the belt, the bragging rights, you know. Who's going to take?
Yeah, you look at this. Both of these fighters have already fought over 24 minutes today.
Wow.
That's a long time. That's a lot of fighting.
Yeah. It sure is.
So I think we said earlier, you know, the endurance is definitely going to be a big factor in future Karate Pro fights.
There he goes again.
Yeah, look at take that throw. Down. Adham had a good punch, but Khalid came right back with a throw. Didn't have a follow-up, so it's probably just a point, but it was a good throw.
And the thing of it is, you can't score and stop. That's the
exactly.
Key with this.
Yep.
You have to defend yourself at all times.
Absolutely.
And keep your eyes on your opponent, etc.
Right. Yeah, it's definitely got its similarities and differences from WKF fighting.
Yes, yes.
In that the techniques, the points are very similar, but you don't have that celebration of a point like you do in WKF. If you celebrate after you think you've scored, guess what? You're going to get scored on.
Right. Well, we got 44 seconds left in this last round. We need to.
This is.
I would be putting it. I'd be moving. Yeah.
There we go. Yeah, I think you got to empty the gas tank and give it everything. There goes.
Oh, no,
what
no,
a throw. Another beautiful throw.
Well, he'll get a point for the takedown.
He will.
Yes.
Adham might have gotten a point for a punch on the way in, but he got flattened.
People are loving it, though. People are loving it.
Absolutely. 15 seconds left in the match.
Boy, I'd be moving if it
boom, being yep.
Me.
Here they go. Yep. They know it.
Seven.
Look at that kick.
Oh, just spin kick. Oh, they're
tips
both trying.
For kicks. Trying to make a score. There you go.
Two. 2 seconds left on the clock. And there
that's
it is.
It.
Now, to the scorekeepers.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a final match. Let's give it up for these competitors. Fantastic fight. And now here we are at the final presentation for the Karate Pro Championships. $15,000 to the winner, $10,000 to the other opponent. And we're waiting on the judges' tally of the points to
to find out who is going to take home that championship belt, as well as a $15,000 check. We hope you've enjoyed this time at not only the Karate Pro Championships, but the Mr. Olympia Sports Fest and all of the vendors, the sports here, 22 sports highlighted here at today's event, and the inauguration of Karate Pro in the United States. And we'd like to thank everyone who helped out, all the volunteers, all the referees, judges, our coordinators, with our internet. Don't forget, there's going to be a live internet feed this evening, starting at midnight, on KaratePRoLive.com. So if you'd like to watch these championships, make sure you tune in to KaratePRoLive.com. All right, we have a decision from the judges. And the judges score it 2-1 for our champion and $15,000 winner and the championship belt to Red, the USA, Adham Sabri. And congratulations to both of our athletes. What a tremendous fight and a tremendous day of competition. And thank you to all of the athletes who competed today and came from all corners of the globe to compete at the Karate Pro Championships. And our congratulations to our champion, Adham Sabri from USA, from New York. And our second place winner for $10,000 from Kazakhstan, Khalid Khalidov. Let's give it up for all these athletes in the red from the Netherlands. Weighing 71 kilos, 157 pounds, welcome Vanessa Norton! And in the blue, from Kazakhstan, weighing 62 kilo, 136 pounds. Welcome, Guzalia Gafurova. Now, this is going to be a little bit different because this is a continuous fighting type of event. So how do you see that being a little different from what you've done with WKF?
That's more statistics, but we will see. Probably more physical, but...
Got to get stick and move, right? Now this, you're going to be competing in the Karate Pro. New rules, different type of surface here. We're not on a tatami, we're in a karate ring. How do you think that's going to make things different for you?
Соревнования проводятся то, что на татами, ой, без татами в ринге. И какие твои ощущения и вообще впечатления об этом турнире?
Давно хотела попробовать себя в таких соревнованиях. Мне это... Для меня это очень... Сейчас.
Ну, говори.
Ага.
Интересно?
Да, для меня это очень интересно. Я очень рада, что попала на эти соревнования. Надеюсь, выкладусь на все 100%. Буду стараться работать в основном в атаке. Эти соревнования, надеюсь, будут для меня...
She coming in the Las Vegas the first time, and he fighting in the Karate Pro the first time. Before the many times looking in the Kazakhstan is Karate Pro tournament, but in Kazakhstan, in the female not fighting, only male. But in the Las Vegas, she coming is very interesting in the this tournament, and she hoping the winner this tournament, and tomorrow the 100% in the job, in the fighting, in the attack, only attack in the, because the new rules in the no tatami, only ring. She's thinking the only attack in the takedown, attack, takedown, and she hoping to win.
Good luck, ladies, let's do it! All right, Toki, we are in the first round of the ladies' match, the only ladies' match of the evening. And so this is for all the marbles right here. And these ladies are starting off fast and strong. Pretty kick by Guzalia from Kazakhstan. And a nice attempt at a takedown. Vaneska from the Netherlands, she held on to block any type of follow-up after that takedown by Guzalia. Nice exchange by both ladies. Vanessa Norton from the Netherlands is 34 years old. She's coming in at about 157 pounds. And it's interesting, Vanessa, there she goes, taking down Guzalia. Maybe a score for a three-pointer there, possibly. But Vanessa works at a youth prison. So you know she's probably not... She's probably very familiar with mixing it up with people. She's been training 18 years. And she goes in hard. She started, interesting, Vanessa started karate because her mom practiced karate. So it was kind of one of those things where the family that kicks together sticks together. And she's a three-time European champion, three-time medalist at the World Championships as well, and a multinational champion many times over in her home country of the Netherlands. So here we go, beginning of round two for the first place match, and both ladies punching hard toward the head. Nice duck of the kick by Guzalia. That kick would have been right there by Vanessa if Guzalia hadn't ducked that one out. And there's an attempt to throw, and it is blocked. Both these ladies very aggressive, very technically sound. And another attempt to throw, but look at Guzalia hang on.
That is one way to stop him from throwing you down. Good forward offense by Vaneska, broken up by the ref. Kick and punch by Vaneska. Again, trying to use that lead hand, that hand that's closest to the opponent. Another attempt at a throw, and the ref breaks. That lead hand, it's got the shortest distance to travel from your body to the opponent's body, so they love to use that front hand. Oh, nice attempt at a spinning kick. Don't think that one would have scored, though. Wasn't a clean hit. And that's the end of round two. Vaneska from the Netherlands in the red, and Guzalia from Kazakhstan in the blue, and here they go. Nice attempts by both ladies at kicking. This is the final match, so they really want to try to impress the judges here. It's really not all about impressing the judges. You just have to score points. This is a point match, so they've got to score the points.
And the strategy is to try to get those multiple points.
Yeah, absolutely, and that was a nice punch by Vaneska, but then Guzalia took Vaneska down.
Went after that takedown follow through.
She's going for it. Toki, you know, all night long, it has just been impressive. These athletes, all of them are of the same status, the same elite level. It's just been impressive.
Oh, absolutely. So you have these women that, if you put them in a suit, you don't want to be a chauvinist, but if you did, you would never know that that they were fighters.
Right.
Oh,
right.
There it comes right back.
Oh, yeah. Down to 20 seconds, and that may have been a three-pointer right there for Vaneska. Good kick. Here comes Guzalia right back after it.
These girls are going after the cash.
That's it. $6,000 for first place. They're down
four,
to 4 seconds.
Three.
Punch, punch,
there
punch,
we
punch,
go.
Point, point, point. Man.
So here we're going to the scorecards. And we'll see you in the ring for the presentation.
First place winner takes home $6,000. Second place, not bad either, gets to take home $3,000. And the Karate Pro Championship belt. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, awaiting the decision of the judges for the ladies division of the Karate Pro Championships.
Let's put our hands together for these fighters. They flew from around the world to come here and put a show on for you, and now they're going to receive the fine, reap of the reward. Now, what we're going to do first, we're going to tell you who the winner is. Second, we're going to present the second place award, and then we're going to present the first place award.
All right. And our winner, in the red from the Netherlands, Vanderschrick Norton! Congratulations, Vanessa, and great fight, Guzalia. Wonderful sportsmanship, and here is the championship belt. Just like a heavyweight champion of the world. And here is the sensei from Kazakhstan, the creator of KaratePRO, presenting the check for $6,000 to Vanessa. Congratulations, Vanessa. Now to present our second place prize to Guzalia Gafurova from Kazakhstan, $3,000. Congratulations, ladies, and thank you for a terrific match. Let's hear it for them. All right, so that's going to be it from Las Vegas from the first KaratePRO Championships. What do you think of the day, Toki?
Darren, it was off the hook. That's all I can say. Besides the great venue, the great fighters, the great, all the celebrities, all the volunteers, everybody, what a great show. And I'll tell you what, if you didn't enjoy that, you don't like karate.
That is the truth, Toki. And, you know, I got to say congratulations to you on promoting this first event. You did an awesome job, and you've got a team that's incredible.
Thank you.
I'll say that because I'm on the team, but, you know. It's really been a fun. It's been a great event, and to be here in Vegas at the Mr. Olympia contest and to put KaratePRO on display here, that was a phenomenal task, and great congratulations.
Well, I look forward to working with you next year, Darren. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
For all you viewers, let us know what you thought.
And check us out at KaratePRO.live.com tonight at midnight, or right now, and be able to see these fights again.
And you can also reach us at KaratePRO.org. Thank you very much. I'm Toki Hill.
I'm Darren Myers from Las Vegas, Nevada. Good night, everyone.